Hello for Monday, December 10th. No market charts today because they're in the newsletter, stocktiger.net, upper top right-hand corner. You'll find the link to them. Loads of charts over there and some very interesting videos as well. So please take a look there. You know, last week we had some of the breakouts just continued nicely. Lately, in the last couple weeks prior to then, it was hard to find good setups. And some stocks, of course, continue. But a lot of them would break out one day and then pull back. But last week, that was improving. Also, it's a little better to find. You'll see some of these setups are pretty nice to start off the week with. We have ADT over $46. You can see increased volume the latter part of December. Then it pulled back to test that 20-day. We like that when it does that and then successfully moves up. It was up 3.8% on Friday. Once again, increased volume above the average volume. So if this can break out over that 46 area, we're interested in that. Along with FCFS over about 49.14 also looked pretty decent. The day that it dipped on Thursday, much, much lower volume, then back up again on Friday, kind of consolidating sideways like that. So it can go a while, maybe continues like that. Notice that we've had the EMA crossover into the good bullish position with the 20-day above the 50 recently. Now it's gone the sideways. It looks like it's going to be a try to move higher, at least. GTAT isn't quite as good a setup with all this kind of resistance. However, once again, it ran into the 20-day, pulled down below it, and then was able to break back above it on Friday. It may sit in this area a little while, and then maybe a move back over that 362 or the high of the day, 365. Notice that Williams has not even broken back above 80 yet. Let's look at RSI, did so in the middle of November. So both of those are suggesting, or at least the RSI suggesting, it's going to try harder. If this breaks up above 80, then some more volume might come in and some more people as well. It was negative up in here and it may have to overcome it. And maybe the first target then would be up to that 50-day, which is at 410. LIFE, $50.16 was high on Friday. 50.11 was that before. Had increasing volume as well. We just have the 20-day about to move over the 50-day. They're not far apart. At the moment, they're pretty close with the 20-day at 48.42 and the 50-day at 48.46. So 4 cents separates them. If it moves over, of course, that's a bullish configuration. So we'll look forward to a move over the high of the day, which is 50.16. And a run at the beginning up to that 51.47 where it was a high before. PSX 52.76 was a recent high. Also had increased volume on Friday. Nothing wrong with the chart at the moment. It pulled back. Didn't even get down as far as the 20-day. It's moving back up. We hope to see a breakout attempt there. And how about TPLM over 6.36? It closed just barely over its 200-day. Now, this is a totally bearish setup. In other words, EMAs are, we've got the 200-day, then the 50-day, then the 20-day moving average is a totally reversed. But with a move back up and a breakout, then the 50-day would start moving over the 200-day. So these things could reverse as well. Anyway, we think this is logical to watch this one. And on good volume, a 636 would be the trade here. Anyway, that's all we have to start off the week. But do check the newsletter because we do have a lot of charts there. And I see some interesting videos as well. Otherwise, of course, we send tweets out before the market opens in the morning and during the day as things develop also. So please check those out. Have yourself a great trading day. And thanks a lot for watching. We'll be back again Monday night with some new additions in Market Wrap. Thanks. Bye.